So YouTube, team keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And in this video, we done finally made it. We done finally made it through the slow season and now training camp is here. And again, the preseason is literally right around the corner. So things are about to pick up a lot. Things are about to get very crazy. But congratulations to y'all for making it through. Y'all made it through the summer. Y'all made it through the off season. So now that's done because training camp is here. But with training camp, you get the players in pads, you get some real practices, you get some physical practices, and you can really determine who the best of the best is. But at the same time, you also get sort of the bad news. You get the more in-depth injury updates, the more in-depth injury reports. And yesterday was no different because it came out that Ronnie Stanley had been placed on the physically unable to perform list. Now, he, of course, wasn't the only person that was placed on that. It was also Nick Boyle, Atara Alaka, and Eamon Marshall. But before we get into those and each of those players and how it could impact them, what is the physically unable to perform list? Well, it's self-explanatory. You are physically unable to perform your job. You can't practice. You obviously can't play if you can't practice. So with them, and we know that these were guys that were hurt last year. Starting off with Ronnie Stanley, he got injured last year, and we're hoping that training camp, he can be cleared by training camp, and he can be back sooner rather than later, and definitely by preseason and all that. I wouldn't expect him to play in the preseason if he is cleared, but we certainly need Ronnie Stanley full go. But with the physically unable to perform list, as long you can come off of that list at any time before the regular season starts. You can come off any time. As long as you can practice, you'll be removed from the physically unable to perform list. Now, with that list, if you go into the regular season on the physically unable to perform list, then you have to miss at least the first 6 weeks of the season. If you're on that list, you have to miss the first 6 weeks of the season. Now, say for instance, and this is obviously a worst case scenario, I don't expect it to happen to any of these players. You never know, but I still don't expect it. But it has happened before, and it will happen again to players in the future. If you start the regular season on the physically unable to perform list, and so you miss the first 6 weeks of the season, but after the first 6 weeks, you either have to be activated to the roster, or you have to be placed on injured reserve. Now, I'm not sure if the physically unable to perform list rules have changed, because we know a lot of the injury reserve rules have changed. But what it has been for the longest is that if you're on that list for the first 6 weeks and you're not able to get activated to the active roster and you go on injury reserve, then you're done for the season. It's a wrap. You cannot come back. Your season is over. Finished. It's done. So with these guys, again, like I said, I don't expect it to happen, but you never know. Now, just going over these players, Ronnie Stanley, of course, one of the best left tackles in football. And we certainly, like last year was enough already without Marshall Yanda. That was a huge enough blow. But then when Ronnie Stanley went down too, and just this whole offensive line was just in shambles throughout the entirety of the year. And like I said, that was their problem literally from week one. From week one, the offensive line was a big issue. From week one, even when everybody was healthy, it was an issue. Then people started going down, and it was just rough, man. So hopefully Ronnie Stanley can be back full go. There won't be any setbacks because Ravens need him badly. And then somebody else who was also on the physically unable to perform list, the PUP list, that was Nick Boyle. And while he is a tight end, he had a huge impact on the offensive line as well, because Nick Boyle, while he does have some really good hands, I think his hands are his catching hands, because we know he got them blocking hands, but his catching hands are a very underrated part of his game that I feel like doesn't get talked about enough, because Nick Boyle is not a dropper. Now, of course, his opportunity, he doesn't have the same number of opportunities that a Mark Andrews has. Because, of course, that's all. Whenever you start to talk about the drops with somebody, you always got to keep in mind the number of opportunities that they have. The more opportunities, that increases their opportunities for drops. But anyway, Nick Boyle, his hands are really good. But he was a huge part of that offensive line when he served as a blocker. And when Nick Boyle went down, while Eric Tomlinson, he did a good job filling in, but at the same time, he was not Nick Boyle. And it would be unfair of us to expect him to be. Nick Boyle, it changed the Ravens game a lot when they lost him. Because, again, you essentially, my guy DT Viz said it best before. He said that the tight ends, they're like an extra lineman. They're like an extra offensive lineman. They're like offensive linemen who can catch. So when Nick Boyle went down, it was huge. So, again, hopefully for him, he'll be back soon, too. I know he was on the podcast with Ryan Mink and Garrett Downing recently. I haven't got a chance to listen to it yet myself, but I did see some little clips and whatnot from it and heard some little sound bites from it. But he was talking about that. He can't put a timetable yet when he's coming back. He said he has been running. He's been cutting and stuff, but he can't put a timetable on when he'll officially be back. But we expect that to be pretty soon. So we'll see what happens with him. Now, Atara Alaka, this is where things get a bit shaky. Because we know Ronnie Stanley, he's a lock to make the roster. We know Nick Boyle is a lock to make the roster. But Atara Alaka, I remember watching him two preseasons ago. I believe he was number 50. This guy was like flying around the ball and he was like making all these tackles. And he was one of those guys that you fall in love with in the preseason because it's like, man, this dude is moving. Just imagine him with the regular defense. Just imagine him, even if he's a reserve linebacker. Because he obviously wouldn't be the starter because Ravens already have their guys. But just imagine him being able to fly around on the field, getting opportunities and whatnot. But then I believe they said he had an injury of some sort. But this is why the preseason is so important. Now it's a lesson preseason. So guys are going to have even fewer opportunities to really show their stuff. But this is... This really hurts his chances of making the roster because it was already borderline anyway. But now with him being on the PUP list, the physically unable to perform list, that makes it that much tougher. And then Eamon Marshall, man, it's like I don't know what's going on with him. It just seems like he just cannot catch a break, man. He can't catch a break. And he, like, even if he was healthy, and again, these guys could come off the physically unable to perform list anytime between now and before the season starts. But with Eamon Marshall, even if he was healthy, he has a long ladder to climb when it comes to making this Ravens roster. Because their top four cornerbacks set. Maybe even their top five with Anthony Averett too. But again, Humphrey, Peters, Jimmy Smith, Tavon Young. Those are your locks. Unless something crazy happens, which I don't expect it to. But those guys are your locks. And then you throw Anthony Averett in there too. So that would be five. They drafted Sean Wade. He ain't going nowhere. That would be six. Already you got six cornerbacks. Already. So then you also have Khalil Dorsey, and there's another one that I'm forgetting. Not Devontae Harris because he's like cornerback safety, but there's another one that I know I'm forgetting. I cannot think of his name right now. I can't think of his name. Wow, my apologies. It's just not coming to mind. But he's in an uphill battle, and especially because he hasn't played yet. That's what makes it even tougher for him. He hasn't even played yet. So with that being said, it's like you got to feel like, ooh, I don't know, man. I don't know. So we'll see what ends up happening, man. Hopefully all these guys can come off of the physically unable to perform list very, very soon. Because that will mean they have a fighting chance. Not only for the Ravens roster, and again, obviously Nick Boyle and Ronnie Stanley, they'll be straight. They're going to make the roster, but with Atara Alaka and Eamon Marshall, worst case scenario, if they don't make Ravens roster, if they didn't and they didn't make the practice squad, then they will still have an opportunity to go show somebody else their stuff. So hope these guys can get well soon and they can be back out there ready to go. Love y'all, team. Keep it clean. Appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for listening, and we out.